Hey there, welcome. My name is Anthony, and today in this video I'm going to go through my experience of installing my own solar panels on the roof of my house, and then we'll go through the cost breakdown of what it actually cost me. So my story is, basically, I was interested in installing solar panels for a long time. I like the idea of generating my own electricity, some self-reliance aspect there. There's also the cost savings. If you can get it done for cheap enough, then you have free electricity potentially for many years. I had heard of the prices of solar installations being, $25,000, $35,000, and just it wasn't feasible. But one day I had a solar installation or salesman come by, and he gave me a general proposal for what would work for my home. And his proposal was cheaper than I expected. And so, for instance, he quoted me a system size of 4.64 kilowatts, and he said that that would cost $17,632. And then when you subtract the 30% federal tax credit, which is good and through the end of 2019, that would take off $5,290. And then the Utah state tax credit was $2,000 last year. It has now gone down $400 from that, so it's at $1,600 right now, and it will continue going down another $400 per year for the next several years. So subtracting that, though, brought the price down to $10,342. Now, that got my attention. That's within the realm of feasibility in my budget. And so I was surprised to learn it had come down so much, and it got me thinking. I still sent him off. I didn't have the money saved just then. I told him, maybe later. But I started to Google, what are the costs of solar installation. I checked with a few other companies, trying to find out what their price per watt would be. And then I started to get the idea of, what if I could do this myself? I'm a pretty handy person around the house. I try to do a lot of things myself. I don't have any construction background. My background is actually primarily in computers, but I do like technology, and this is kind of a technology, right? And so after I watched quite a few YouTube videos of how to install various components of the solar system, I started to realize that I could do the rooftop portion myself. The main breaker, if that needs to get replaced, or the interconnection with the main breaker, that I wasn't so confident about. And so I started looking around for a local electrician who would potentially be able to do the parts that I couldn't or didn't feel qualified to do myself. And I ended up finding an installer, an electrician that had experience installing solar, that was willing to just work for me hourly doing the parts that I wanted him to do for me. And so I decided to have him help me with just the general design after I'd had a chance to do some of the design myself, and in doing a bunch of Googling about various ways to design the system, different hardware to use, I came up with a general plan myself and then sent it to him. He reviewed my plan, gave me some feedback, and discussing with this with the electrician, we determined that the main panel would need to be replaced to accommodate the incoming 40-amp breaker from the solar. And he was also able to recommend some other components, such as roof tar, some caulking for the roof, some lag bolts, and things like that that he included in, through getting the equipment from him. So I recognized early on that one of the big time commitments to getting solar actually was the permit, doing all of the paperwork and pulling that permit. And so I decided to take that on myself to save costs, and it seemed like something I should be capable of doing. And so I found some software online that I was able to use to draw exact dimensions. And I went up on my roof and measured everything on my roof, and then inputted the exact dimensions of the panels, the size of the panels would be on the roof, so that I could figure out what orientation and layout they would be and how many I could fit. So then I started looking at what panel to get, because the more efficient, the higher wattage output they have, the more expensive they are. And so I looked at a couple of different options, LG, 310 watt panels, and couple of others, and I ended up going with the REC TP2 panels. They are 290 watt panels, and I felt like that was a high enough wattage system. It was already oversized for the size that I would need for my house, but it would save me some money in the installation as well. So that would bring the size of the system on my house to a 6.38 kilowatt system. So like I said, oversized for what my home would actually need. My home on an annual basis would be serviced by about a 5 kilowatt system based on my average consumption. But I wanted to be able to get an electric car. I wanted to be able to just have excess electricity so that I wouldn't even need to worry about my usage too much. I could be somewhat liberal with it, and it'd be just fine to be within, you know, the what the production of my system was providing. And because I was installing the system myself, it was relatively cheap to just make the system bigger. I also decided to go with the SolarEdge hardware. I did power optimizers paired with a string inverter rather than doing the micro inverters. Part of the reason for that is just that the string inverter is more efficient. And also the micro inverters tend to fail more regularly because they're on the hot roof. They've got sensitive electronics inside of them that tend to fail over time. And the power optimizers are much more bulletproof, and paired with the string inverter, they still have the same benefits as, you know, being able to have your panels operate independent of each other. If one has shade, it doesn't affect the others, etc. I also got my string inverter larger than was needed. I got a 7600 watt string inverter with the intention of potentially adding some additional panels down the road if I needed to, especially if I was able to get a second electric car someday or something like that. So that was just a little bit of future proofing. The string inverter did not cost hardly anything more than like the 6000 watt inverter did, so it was just fine. So I ended up in purchasing the hardware through my electrician. I mean the solar panels, the inverter, the racking, and everything. I had checked with a couple of other sources, and his pricing was competitive with them, so I just decided to go with him since he was supporting me with the installation. He had them shipped directly to my house. I had pallets of them brought into my garage. And then I got to work. After I got the permit, I went up on my roof, and this was in July, so it was very hot. But I'd go up in the evening just for a few hours in a couple of evenings with a cordless drill and a couple of other tools, which I'll link in the description down below. And basically went through the process of installing all of the footings, the mounts on the roof that have flashing over the top of them. And you use tar to make sure that there's no leakage into the house, etc. Once all the footings were installed, then I was able to put all of the rails across those. And the SnapNrack system was awesome to use. I highly recommend it. Very easy to figure out. And then I was able to carry the panels up on the roof and install those. I also, in the meantime, had the electrician scheduled, and he came over. We had the power to the house shut off. He had to remove the main breaker to the house, install the new one, and then had to have the city come and do their inspection so that we could turn the power back onto the house. Then we had to have them come back and do a second inspection later once all of the panels were on the roof and everything, since they required there to be two inspections in that order. And so the majority of the labor of the electrician was actually spent doing the main panel replacement and the conduit bending around and up to the roof. And then he installed a junction box at the end of the conduit up on the roof, connected to the rails that I had installed, the SnapNrack rails. And so I was able to take my wiring from the solar panels and connect them all in series. We did two strings in series at 11 panels each, and connect them into that junction box with the connectors that he had left behind. Okay, so that was my story and my experience in getting my solar panels installed, or installing them myself. So now the information you really want to know probably is, what did the final cost breakdown look like? And so the solar panels, the optimizers, the inverter, and the racking all came to $10,114.20. The permit fees were $410, and keep in mind that built into that price is the cost of an engineering firm to write up a engineering letter certifying my roof to be able to handle the weight of the solar panels. And then the main breaker components, the parts and the miscellaneous solar parts that were needed, the conduit and whatnot, that came to $646.29. And then the labor of the electrician to do the main panel replacement and to install the conduit came to $1,237.50. So that brings my total cost to $12,408.03. And that's for a 6.38 kilowatt system. My average quote from a solar installer company for this size of system was just over $23,000. So quite a bit of savings there, but a lot of sweat equity went into that price reduction and some stress and a lot of time. So keep that in mind. So then after the federal tax credit of 30% off, which is good through the end of 2019, and then also after the Utah's $2,000 tax credit comes off of that, the final cost after those rebates brought it down to $6,685.62. So that's 53.88% of the overall price. So nearly half of the out-of-pocket cost to buy all of the equipment and pay for the electrician's labor ended up being paid for through tax rebates. So pretty awesome deal. So my before tax rebate price per watt was $1.94 per watt, and so then after the tax rebate that brought it down to $1.04 per watt installed. So much cheaper than your solar installation companies. You'll find if you ask them what their price per watt is, it's probably up $3 or something, up in that range. So I kept asking myself after I finished this, like, would I go through this again? Would I go through this effort and the amount of time for the cost savings and to have solar on my roof? And my conclusion is yes, I would do it again, keeping in mind that I was under some timeline restrictions of the tax rebate being only good in Utah for full $2,000 through the end of 2017. Also, Rocky Mountain Power. Here in Utah, we use Rocky Mountain Power, and their net metering for solar was going to be changing, and I wanted to make sure I got grandfathered in to the old method of net metering, which is much more favorable. It's a 1-to-1 ratio. And so all that being said, yes, I would do it again. But it definitely takes a certain personality type to be able to pull this off without having prior experience and doing it alone. I have a lot of attention to detail. I have a general engineering mindset. I like technology, and all of that was a combination for success, but it was somewhat stressful. So I don't necessarily recommend this for everybody, but the end result's awesome, and I'm definitely glad that I did it. So my system went online August 14th of 2017. And so that was a partial day, and so basically by the end of August 14th of 2018, I will then have a complete year of power production. And I'm going to be able to use that data to extrapolate out what my break-even point will be, and that's what I'm excited to see. I'm going to be making another YouTube video about that so that I can share with you what my break-even point will be. And so if you want to be able to see that video, feel free to subscribe to this channel and you'll be getting a notification automatically when that video is published. I'm going to be making some other videos as well, such as the SolarEdge monitoring portal. They have an online website that you can see your power output and production, and as well as a mobile app. I'll be doing another video on the solar permit process and what all the paperwork looked like and what that took to get that approved, and potentially some other videos. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below, and I potentially will make a video about comments that I see in common. So what do you think? Has my video convinced you to do your own solar, or maybe scared you away from it? Have you learned something you didn't know before? Feel free to share in the comments below what you think. And with that, have a great day, and thanks for watching.